What comes over you with 5 minutes to go?
Well, you know, first and foremost, you know, I got to thank my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, and thank my teammates.
But nationally, I've never seen a guy that provokes so much talk, good or bad. What do you feel like attributes to that?
Well, you know, I'm not sure, but I know one thing is, you know, I'm extremely blessed. You know, God has blessed me with so many people that support me, you know, a great family that supports me, great teammates, and a great coaching staff, and that's what I'm focused on.
But do you feel like it's your throwing motion, it's your faith? What is it that provokes anger or hatred or disdain from some journalists and publicists?
Well, you know, I'm not sure, but, you know, something I learned early in college was to not worry about what I can't control, and that's something that I can't control. But what I can control is my attitude, my effort, my focus every single day, and that's what I'm trying to worry about.
What'd you say?
Well, you know, he just said, just keep believing. And, you know, we got in the huddle and we just said, you know, this is an opportunity, you know, where great things can happen. And let's be great right now. And that was our focus. And everybody believed. And we went out there and we achieved it. But it was because, one, our faith, and two, you know, our relentlessness. And we're just going to keep fighting. And just find a way. Keep believing, you know, because it's never going to be good. And, you know, people aren't always going to like you, you know, but you have to believe in the people around you and keep fighting, because you're going to get knocked down. But it's not how many times you get knocked down. It's how many times you get back up. And that's something that, you know, my parents have always preached to me, and I believe.
And I would love to just see if this has dawned upon you. Or you.
Well, you know, it is very exciting, and we're very excited about you and the wins that we've been able to put together. But I think, you know, in what you're alluding to earlier, you know, just with the support and everything, I think, you know, the greatest thing for me is we play a game out here, and we're very passionate, as you could see me playing out there today, and I love it and I care about it. But I think the greatest thing with this sport and with the NFL is we have such a platform. And we can take that platform, we can influence the next generation. And, you know, that is honestly my passion. And, you know, this week we got to announce that, you know, I was building a hospital in the Philippines. And this game means a lot, but that hospital means more to me, because that's changing people's lives. You know, that's giving people, you know, faith and hope and love. And, you know, that's more important. And so my ultimate goal with this, with playing football, you know, is to be a great role model that a parent can look at their son and say, you know, that's someone that's trying to do it the right way. He's not perfect, but every day he's trying to get better, and he's trying to honor God and do the right thing, do what's right, and do his best. Thank you all so much.
Congratulations on the hospital, too.
Thank you.
In the Philippines.
God bless.